أخلاق، أنس، شوق، خشية، إقبال to him. Okay? So we really, this is the way we want to know, not just, oh, Allah is good. You ask anybody, do you think Allah is good? Oh, yeah, Allah, of course, is there. Of course, He exists. Okay? But we want to know Him in a better way. Okay? And the more we know Him better, the more we come closer to Him, the more we love Him, the more He loves us also. Okay? So that's the target of the whole thing. And there are two ways, yes.
Have a comment. when we think about what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Quran and Kareem, first, إن في خلق السماوات والأرض واختلاف الليل والنهار لآيات لأولي الألباب. And as far as existence of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, أفي أنفسكم أفلا تبصرون. So look to ourselves, who created us, and say subhanahu wa ta'ala.
That's exactly, you are ahead of me. Okay,
it's good to discuss.
You are ahead of me, and thanks for reminding me because I'm going to mention that. Okay. So anyway, so we know Allah through two means. God gave us two means to know Him. Okay, the first one.
Ask them. Maybe nobody knows.
Do you know what are the two means? God, the two tools.
How to know Allah? Yeah.
Through which we know Allah.
Huh? Through what?
We want to make a discussion. That's it.
It's good. It's better. Yes.
Of course.
I love this question. Yes. How to know Allah through two things?
Two things.
Yeah, number one.
Our existence, man.
The creations of Allah.
Creation.
And the second, the verses from the Quran.
Thank you. It's
the Quran. This is the Quran, number one.
Kitab al-Manzoor.
This is the Kitab al-Maqroo.
Nah.
This is the tool, the readable, the thing you can read it. So we know Allah, we know how glorifying Allah. By reading the Quran, by reciting the Quran, not reciting, reciting and understanding and thinking. أَفَلَا تَذَكَّرُونَ أَفَلَا يَعْقِلُونَ أَفَلَا تَدَبَّرُونَ يَتَفَكَّرُونَ. So we think. So that's the first way or first tool God gave it to us to know Him is Al-Kitab Al-Maqroo, which is Al-Quran.
Which is a message from Muhammad alayhi salatu wasalam. That's how it started from the beginning.
And there is another tool. What is it?
أفعال
الكتاب المنظور
أفعال of course أفعال الله his bounties
his creation his Quran and his أفعاله يعني
actions أسماء وصفات وسنة
okay so actually أسماء وصفاته and his creations on the face of the earth so on the face of creation on the face of the earth this is الكتاب المنظور yes. This is the thing we you see it with your eyes So you read, appreciate what he is doing. Right. Okay. So two things: al-kitab al-maqroo, al-kitab al-manzoor. Why you give us two? There's one of them will help because if somebody doesn't know how to read, he has no excuse to say, "I didn't really know you, Allah." No, Allah. You don't know how to read, but you can look, you can imagine, you can dream, you can see ahead of you.
Rasulullah. In the cave of Hira.
He
used to say long nights just to think about.
Just to think about.
Allah. Wonder to think about Allah's creation. That's why he knows Allah through that.
That's true. Yeah. And that was his ibadah. That was his salah, actually. Yeah. Salah is actually tafakkur. Salah is actually dua. It's the same thing. Okay? So ibadah al-ta'amul. So the worship of ta'amul and tafakkur salah for khalq Allah, it was. Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, his ways of worshipping Allah. Before Quran, before Jibreel, before he knows what are the rules of Islam, everything before, he wasn't sitting idle, doing nothing. Of course, he had some connection with Allah. Okay. God says in his holy book to Sayyidina Ibrahim sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, okay, وَكَذَلِكَ نُرِي إِبْرَاهِيمَ مَلَكُوتِ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ So God is addressing Ibrahim sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He said, we show Prophet Ibrahim sallallahu alayhi wa sallam malakut, all the galaxies and samawat and all the great things on the earth and stuff like that. Okay? And then we're going to come to what the Bashmandis said. Allah said in Surah Al-Imran, okay? وَإِنَّ فِي خَلْقِ السَّمَوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ وَاخْتِلَافِ اللَّيْلِ وَالنَّهَارِ لَآيَاتٍ لِأُولِي الْأَلْبَابِ Till the end of it, and then رَبَّنَا مَا خَلَقْتَ هَذَا بَاطِلًا سُبْحَانَكَ فَقِنَا عَذَابَ النَّارِ Okay, So the translation of it, okay, God says in His holy book, okay, in the creation of the skies or the universe and earth and the repetition of day and night, okay, following each other, those are signs for whom? For the people who have brains, for the people who think, for the people who would like to exhaust, to understand, to know all of those things.
That would be called Ulil Albab, right?
Yeah, that's what
means. Okay.
And then in the end of the verse, okay, God says, رَبَّنَا مَا خَلَقْتَ هَذَا بَاطِلًا فَقِينَ عَذَابَ اللَّهِ. God says, okay, God says, oh, I didn't really create those things to be in vain. No, we created for you to think about it, to know me, to glorify me, to appreciate me, to come closer to me, and all of that stuff. Okay? When this verse revealed the Prophet Muhammad
at night,
he was praying, and that was revealed for him, and he was saying, he was reciting it, and he started crying, and he wet all his beard, and he went to the point that he wet the floor. Okay? So Jibreel told him, why Prophet Muhammad, why are you crying? His Prophet Muhammad said, well, وَيْلٌ لِمَنْ يَقْرَأُهَا وَلَمْ يَفْهَمَهَا وَلَمْ يَتَضَبَّرْ فِيهَا وَلَمْ يَتَمَعَنْهَا. Okay, so Jibreel asked Sayyidina Muhammad, why are you crying? Why are you so sad? It's a nice verse. He said, well, it is nice, but I hope, you know, everybody reads it, will really think about it, okay, and understand it. It has a big meaning, okay? وَيْلٌ, this is very bad part of Jahannam. This is part of Jahannam. وَيْلٌ لِمَنْ يَقْرَأَهُ وَلَا يَعْقِلْهَا وَلَا يَتَفَهَّمَهَا وَلَا يَتَضَبَّرْ فِيهَا. Okay? And there are so many ahadith or sayings about the Sahaba and stuff like that, okay? It could be ahadith sahiha, it could be daifa, okay? But the idea is we'll take what the hadith says, what is the merit of it, okay? Alright, so for example, okay, Abu Darda, that's one of the big Sahaba, okay? He said, التفكر في خلق الله أفضل عبادة. Thinking of creation of Allah is the best worship. He said that. That's what one of the Sahaba, he said that. Al-Hasan, the grandson of Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, he said, إن نور الإيمان هو التفكر في خلق الله. He said, the light of the إيمان. Of the
believing,
the light of the Nur al-Iman, light of al-Iman.
The reflection of the faith or the
faith. The light of the faith is the thinking of the creation of Allah. Okay, he said, thinking about the bounties of Allah and the creation is one of the best.
Why? What's the question?
Why?
Why, doctor?
Why? I don't know.
He said, if you think 1 hour better than worshiping Allah 1 year, why? What is the point? Why?
Tafakkur.
What's the difference? Yeah. What's the difference between tafakkur? Let's finish with this because 30 minutes now. Everybody wanna go. Yeah. Why?
I think because it make you closer to Allah Subhanahu Wa Taala. Because you think about all the surrounds, make you iman more strong.
Yes, and can it change your life? Yani, can it change your life? Imagine somebody worshipping an idol. And they said, this is what happened to the Sahaba. And they sit like this and they're thinking, what this idol is? Talk. Hey, you're my God? Talk. I'm going to think. Even if he doesn't know nothing. God cannot defend even himself. What is it? What kind of idol this? I'm just giving you an example. Yeah. And when he will recognize, he will look for something better. Like Salman the Pharisee. Salman al-Farisi, they name him al-Bahith al-Haqiq. He used to search for the truth, He came from Iran, Persian. And he, subhanAllah, he found a Jewish guy. He said, no, this is not the real deen. And then he found a monk, a preacher. And he said, and he was looking until he found Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Now, it means he used to think. doesn't work, you know, it's not valid. And this is not valid too, it's not good. No. Then he found Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. When you come to that point, this is because he used to think. If you think 1 hour, that can change your life completely. If you think it the right way. But if you become like a monk for years, nothing can change. I'm just making my ibadah gong. That's it. That's why the reflection or the to ponder or to think when you read ayah, like what the doctor said, Al-Kitab al-Makru, Al-Quran al-Kareem. When you read ayah, Ramadan is coming, and you think about it, about what is the murad of this, what is the meaning of this ayah? What Allah want to tell me a certain message. I want to get that message from this ayah. This is thinking. And if you don't know how to read, just look through this universe, this county, whatever around you. When you see a beautiful flower, who created this? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When you see that big ocean, a big animal is in it, subhanAllah. You see, what is this? Allah created this. When you see that beautiful tree, when you see that, mashallah, the sky, when you see, Allah the one who created this. Sometimes, wallahi, I drive my car, I see the clouds came like a beautiful picture. If somebody want to draw it, you cannot draw it. And you look at it and say, Allahu Akbar. Look to the cloud. Who made this? Who draw this? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is Kitab al-Mundur. Think about it. Think about yourself. Look at your, how's your organs in your body function and working together without any contradiction or anything. Then one time I went to the hospital in Louisiana with my friend doctor from Pakistan. It's a heart doctor. He said, Sheikh, let me make some check for you. This before like 12 years. Then the hospital of those who been returned from the army, very good hospital there. And home I went there and they put the machine and he said, listen to your heart. Wallahi, I was listening. He said, La hawla wa quwwata illa billah. Zoom, zoom, zoom. He said, La hawla wa quwwata illa billah. I said, what is this? Is that my heart? What is this? Imagine if you listen to the sound of your heart all the time like this. You cannot sleep. You cannot sleep. It is inside working, making that sound, but you cannot sleep. Your kidney, how is everything working together? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
Furthermore, do you know this sound? Actually, it's a sound of blood going through the vein, whole body. And I was told, you know, the length or the travel, it's like length of a rope around the earth.
Allahu Akbar.
That's how far it goes, subhanAllah. So when you think about all these, think about capability and how great Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is.
Yeah, if you think about this, that's a good subject to put to Allah.
Yeah, but good subject is going to take us, with this rate, we're going to take about 20.
We'll continue.
How many pages they have?
Yeah, next time, inshallah.
This one page, right? You just finished one page.
Next time, inshallah, we're going to say what God creates in the universe.
Yeah, Allah.
Okay. All the planets and stuff like that, and why He chose Earth to be our dominion, to live on it,
good,
rather than the others.
Good.
What's so peculiar? But let me finish by this one verse. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, إن في خلق السماوات والأرض واختلاف الليل والنهار والفلك التي تجري بما ينفع الناس
في البحر
في البحر بما ينفع الناس لآيات لقوم يعقلون. So that's سورة البقرة verse 164. We have to think about the creation of Allah. And also, we don't have to take it for granted. Oh yeah, there is sky, there is rain. Of course, there is sun. How are we gonna live? No. لا تألف النعمة. Don't get used to the bounties of Allah and say, of course, it's gonna be there. Yes. Otherwise, how are we gonna live? Oh, it's raining. Yes, we have to. It has to rain because we have to drink. Okay, there are plants. Oh, of course, it has to be plants because we have to eat. No, these are bounties. God gave it to you, and God He already descended or revealed a surah, verse, chapter, which is the ilafi Quraysh, ilafi Ibrahim al-Shita'i al-Sayf. We can talk about that next time. Okay, inshallah. ونقول دعاء. يا ربنا لك just I have whole bunch of ودعية here so but I'm choosing some of them. اللهم إني دافع الشاء منك. يا ربنا لك الحمد كما ينبغي لجلال وجهك وعظيم سلطانك. ولك الحمد أنت مالك السماوات والأرض ومن فيهن. ولك الحمد لك الحمد أنت قيوم السماوات والأرض ومن فيهن. ولك الحمد أنت الحق وقولك حق وغاتك حق ولقاؤك حق والجنة حق والنار حق والنبيون حق ومحمد صلى الله عليه وسلم حق. اللهم اغفر لنا وتوب علينا يا رحم الرحيمين يا أجود الأجودين يا أكرم الأكرمين يا غفور يا رحيم يا قابل التوبة وغافر الذنب يا رب العالمين. اللهم افتح علينا ونور طريقنا وهدنا إلى ما تحب وما ترضى يا رب العالمين. اللهم فقهنا فيما لا نعلم وعلمنا ما لا نفقه. اللهم انصرنا وارزقنا وبارك لنا في رزقنا يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم اجعل هذا القرآن الكريم ربيع قلوبنا وشفاء لصدورنا وغذاء لأرواحنا وشفيع لزلاتنا وأخطائنا ومرطب لألسنتنا ونور وهاد لنا على الصراط وحافظ لبيوتنا وأولادنا وأزواجنا وشفيع لنا في قبورنا ويوم الحساب. اللهم أنت السلام ومنك السلام تباركت يا ذا الجلال والإكرام. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. And I want to say something بمناسبة شهر رمضان. اللهم املأ قلوبنا وقلوبنا جميعا بالقرآن وجمعنا بكم في ظل الرحمن وبلغنا سويا بركة شعبان وعتق رمضان وغفران الكريم المنان وجمعنا ومن يحبنا في دار الجنان. وصلى الله وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. To buy an iPhone, one of those data phones, okay? Dad, you have to buy them. You have to go with the flow. I mean, everybody has one. Okay, so he bought one finally, he paid whatever is it, $800,000, stuff like that. So it became something valuable to him. Okay, so the guy was very happy and just he put it in the back pocket of his pants. Okay, and he was one time he was sitting, and when he sat, he heard something cracking. Something cracked. Oh my God, and then he said, oh, I hope it's my spine, not the phone.
He's stingy, I know. He'll break his bones, but...